So in the previous quiz, we have seen that we can fetch these instructions, then we rename them to eliminate false dependencies. So let's see whether we have any false dependencies after renaming, and what does that do to our IPC, or instructions per cycle, which is the opposite of CPI. Well, here we had a true dependence, and that true dependence is still there in a rename program. Similarly, here we have a true dependence, and it is still there in our rename program. And then here we have another one, and it is still there. However, here we also have an output dependence from R to here to R to here, and then another one to here. And we have an anti-dependence here, and one here. So if we look at all of the dependencies, then basically this is a sequential program. So for our fetched program, we have the CPI of 1, which is also the IPC of 1. For a renamed program, however, this anti-dependence is no longer there. This output dependence is no longer there. There is no anti-dependence here, and there is no output dependence here. So really, here we can execute this, this, and this instruction in the first cycle, and this, this, and this instruction in the second cycle. So for a rename program, now we have that we can execute this, this, and this instruction, three instructions in the first cycle. These three can be done in the second cycle. So overall, we have six instructions over two cycles. The cycles per instruction is two cycles for six instructions, giving us a much lower CPI of only 0.33, or we can write it as IPC of 3, meaning we execute 3 instructions per cycle. As you can see, our renaming gave us a much better potential for executing this program quickly.